हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू टू ऑनलाइन टीचिंग ईशुविद्या। टुडे वी विल रीड एंड डिस्कस ए वेरी फाइन टॉपिक, स्कूल्स गुड बाय। यू ऑल नो वी बिड गुड बाय, वी से गुड बाय व्हेन वी आर डिपार्टेड फ्रॉम समबडी और फ्रॉम समवेयर। So now you are in class 10 and this topic is especially for you, the 10th class students who are about to leave the school after your exam. Now your test exam is ahead and after test exam you will stay home and prepare for the annual exam, and when the annual exam will be over you will take your certificates, you will pass with divisions, distinctions, then you will come to school and you will take your certificates and testimonials, then you will bid farewell to the school permanently. No more you will come to school, isn't it? So school is a place, it is called the second family. After your family you spent most of the time at your school, and when you took admission in the school you didn't know more about the school, more about the teachers, your friends. All were new to you. Now you are the senior most students of the school, and you have also seen in our school every year we give farewell to the 10th class students after their annual HSC exam. You also participate, you give farewell with some gifts and feast to your elder brothers when you are in class 9. Now you all are in class 10 and you will take farewell. So when you will take farewell and you will say goodbye to your school, definitely you will feel unhappy, you will feel sad. Am I clear? Yes. Because you are emotionally attached with the school, with the students, with the hostel, with your friends, with the playground, with the school surrounding, and it is obvious, definitely you will feel sad when you will be departed from the school. So here today we will read a topic, School's Goodbye, and its author is Lord Eustace Percy. So Lord Eustace Percy was the former Minister of Education in Britain, and he was also the president of Education Board of Britain. So in this chapter, in this topic, Lord Eustace Percy the writer, he wants to convey a message to the class students of 10th class students when they are about to leave the school. He also wants to extend his best wishes along with all other teachers, the teacher community, to the students of class 10. And he hopes, he expects the 10th class students, when they will pass, when they will go away of the school, their education will not end there, because we know education is a lifelong process. It starts from the mother's womb and ends in our term. So school education or high school certificate is the foundation stone upon which the superstructure of your higher education lies depends. So you should work hard and do perform good in your exam so that you will get a good division and you will go for higher studies. So let's start the topic and know what Lord Eustace Percy has given as message to the 10th class students. Look at your books. This is your final year in school. You will say goodbye to your school soon after your test exam is over, won't you? Your last day at school will be a sorrowful one as you are going to leave it for good. You won't be able to enjoy life at your school ever again. You feel emotionally attached to your school. When you say goodbye to it, it is like saying goodbye to your own family. But your education does not end here. You move out from school to the wider world to prepare yourself for facing the challenge in life. So the writer says, the high school is the starting point of your life. Your education starts from here, does not end here. After school education, you will go to a wider sphere for higher study, for higher education. There are so many faculties, you will go there and you will build your bright career. So you will not forget, he expects you will not forget your school, you will not forget your teachers, because teachers are your friends, philosophers and guides, they are your mentors. So their blessings will be always with you. You are now about to leave school, and before you go, we desire to send you our best wishes for your future welfare. Although you are parting from school in which you have spent so many years, we hope you will not forget it and think that your education is finished. In whatever trade or profession you desire to follow, you will soon find that. If you are ambitious to succeed in it, you must continue your education. Success in life is not easily secured. It only comes to those who work hard and continue learning. So, dear children, in these paragraphs, there are a few new words like welfare, health and happiness of the people. Our government is doing a lot of work for the public welfare, for the public well-being, for the public use, development. So, welfare means wealth and happiness of the people. Then parting from, part from, departed, leave. So when you will be parting from the school, that means you will be departed from school, you will be departed from your family, you will feel sad definitely. Then ambitious, one having ambition, aim or objective. Everybody must be ambitious. That means we must hope for the best. We should hope that our future will be a bright future. We will be self-sufficient. Our aim will be fulfilled. So each one must be ambitious. We must have some ambition in life. Then secure, achieved, obtained. You must secure good marks in annual HS exam. If you will work hard, you will definitely secure good marks. So here in these paragraphs, the writer gives message to the students, and at the same time he extends his best wishes to the students for performing a good result as well as for a bright future. So you are about to leave the school, that means you have not left the school, still you are in the school. You are about to leave, that means you are going to leave after few days, after your test exam is over. So we desire to send you our best wishes. So we send you our best wishes. We wish best of luck, good luck to you for your bright future. Although you are parting from school in which you have spent so many years, in school you have spent so many years. Some students have 8 years, some 10 years, some 5 years. Somebody has taken admission in the class 1 and continuing till 10. So a long time of your life has been spent in school. When you leave your family, you come to school next. So school is the next family or second family. So you have spent so many years. We hope you will not forget it. So we hope, and you also know, we know you will not forget your school. Wherever you will go, you will remember your school days, you will remember your teachers. And the attachment with the school teachers will not be seen anymore in higher studies, in colleges, in universities. You will not be so attached with the teachers. There will be no so closeness with the teachers. In whatever trade or profession you desire to follow, trade, profession, occupation. Trade means a faculty where there is need of manual labor and some training. He is a carpenter by trade. That means his profession is, his work is carpentry. But Mr. Das is a doctor by profession. So we can use trade or profession interchangeably in ordinary cases. But if we will see minutely, there is a little difference between trade and occupation. A profession. In whatever trade or profession you desire to follow, you will soon find that. So the writer hopes that whatever trade, whatever line you want to go, adopt, definitely you will find, you will get, if you will do well in the annual HSE exam. If you are ambitious to succeed, become successful, succeed is verb, successful noun. The original word succeed, success, successful, succeedingly. So if you want to succeed, you must continue your education. As I have already told, education is a continuous process. It does not stop anywhere. Till death, it continues with us. Success in life is not easily secured. We cannot easily obtain success. We have to work hard. We have to continue learning. Without hard work, success is not achieved. We cannot attain success. It comes only to those who work hard and continue learning. So those students, those people who work hard and continue learning, they can only get success or achieve success. So in these paragraphs, the writer conveys his message and what a student should do after he leaves the school. He has finally explained. So now, are you all clear? Then tell me, who is the writer of this topic, School's Goodbye? Lord Eustace Percy. So this chapter or this topic is a dash for the students, is a message for the 10th class students. Who can attain success, who can achieve success? Those who work hard and continue learning, they can only achieve success. Then we will see in the next class. Thank you.